I guess I'm pretty cool. So this is the 5D Mark III, but pretty much all cameras will have some sort of version of this. On this one, it's a AV out digital is what they call it. But it comes with an adapter cord to make that USB. So you plug this in, and then what you need is an on-the-go cable. Now, all this does is convert the USB from the camera or from any kind of device into the micro USB that you'll be used to on your Android devices. So I have a Sony Xperia Z3 tablet compact. Just as a side note, I think this tablet is awesome, by the way. So you plug this in to the micro USB, turn on your tablet. Now I've installed an app called DSLR Controller, which is available on Google Play Store for $7.99 or something like that. And it's still in beta, but late stage beta, and hopefully we'll have a official release soon. But the beta, aside from a few hiccups sometimes where you have to close and reopen the app or maybe turn the camera on and off, it works really well. All you have to do once you're hooked up and your tablet's running is turn on the camera. It sends the signal to the app launches. This is just giving me a warning because I've taken the autofocus off of the shutter button and put it only on the AF on, where the app likes it if you have the shutter also actually the autofocus. But you can just press OK, you don't have to change it. I'll put something in the background, like this, okay. So now you can do a couple cool things. You can adjust your aperture directly from the app. You can adjust the autofocus point like that, and there's tap to focus, which is pretty cool. You can set your shutter speed. So let's set it to, and you can scroll up to the ones, whatever, just set it to something like 1/60. And set your ISO. We'll just put it on auto so we don't have to mess around with it right now. So there you go. And you can see everything in live view. It's just like if you were using Capture One or an Adobe product ever, but you can use it from an Android device. So this opens up a lot of possibilities. Think if you were videoing with yourself and you didn't have a camera that had a flip-down screen or flip-out screen, like the 5D Mark III or the 7D Mark II, for instance. Then you can mount this tablet on your tripod or with a Gorillapod, like this one right here, which is meant for tablets. I'll show you that in a second. You can mount it on that, and you'll be able to see yourself in the footage. So I'll do a quick demo of that. Also, you can activate the shutter right here. And shows you here, now you're actually looking at the card on the camera. But now you're given the options where you can transfer it locally to the storage on the Android, or you can share it directly from here. So think about the implications of that for cameras that don't have built-in Wi-Fi. You can take the picture, immediately view it, and immediately send it out. And for cameras that don't have Wi-Fi, the app also doubles as sort of a hotspot. So it now uses the USB through the tablet to use the tablet as the Wi-Fi antenna. On the other side, you have your modes. Right now we're in manual, whether you want autofocus, what sort of focus types you want, white balance, the scene optimizer. You can hit the playback button to go through and view your photos. And you can view photos from earlier that are still stored on the card. You also have your EV, your amount of images remaining at your current setting, and a view of your battery life. Another great thing that it has as a feature is if you set your camera into bulb mode, which for anybody that doesn't know, bulb is a setting in which the shutter is held as long as you hold it. It's held open as long as you hold it. So typically you would have a cable release, you would push the button, hold it for as long as you want it, then when you let go, the shutter is released. Or you can hold and lock it, and whenever you feel like enough light's been let in, then you can release it. Well, in bulb mode, when you press the shutter, it activates the bulb, and right now the shutter is open. And it's staying open. There's a timer in the middle of the screen. It's staying open until I release it by pressing it again. So I release it, I press it again, and release it, and as expected, the picture is wildly overexposed because it had like several seconds of light coming into it. But that's a great feature if you want to do night shots where you need to have a really long exposure and you can't be touching the camera because you don't want it to move. You're now touching the tablet and you saved yourself the $100 that Canon charges for their cable release. Now, I want to show you the feature that I'm excited about. So, now I can see what I'm filming, and if I look into the tablet or looking in the camera, it's not that much different. I can set up the tablet beneath. It's basically just having a monitor set up like this. And I can make adjustments to my image on the fly. So this is a great tool for any people who want to shoot video, who don't have the ability to review themselves and don't want to set up a monitor or a TV or looking at their computer the whole time. I've seen a lot of videos where people are looking at their computer back and forth. So to give you an example, it would look like this. I'd be like, yeah, so it's important to... And they're trying to line up the shot. But you don't have to do this. You place the tablet directly below or directly above. And now when I look into the tablet, it looks like I'm looking into the camera. So that's awesome. I'm super excited about this. And I think I'm going to start using it for everything that I do. So the next thing I want to show you, which will kind of double as an unboxing, is the Joby GripTight Gorillapod stand for smaller tablets. Similar to the product that I did an unboxing for, the Gorillapod Focus, but it's for smaller tablets. So, instruction booklet, box, pretty straightforward, and then two components. So you've got a Gorillapod, just like the big one in the Focus. This one is plastic though, it's not made of metal like the Focus is. It's lighter, obviously, but it doesn't need to support as much. Quarter inch on the top. And then you've got your tablet holder like this, spring-loaded. You can get a little adapter like this, and all it is a hot shoe mount, hot shoe piece on the bottom with a tightener for that, and a tightener for the quarter inch peg that runs through it. So you slide this into your hot shoe, and then screw this one down so it's nice and tight. Take the tablet grippy guy. Now let's do it like this, because we'll assume that we're going to be looking into the camera and filming ourselves. So there's a quarter inch socket on the bottom there. Just thread that on. And then you can use the other tightener to tighten it like that. And then there you go. So, and it's pretty secure. The grip tight from Joby is really good. Give you kind of like a... Now you're not going to want to thrash it around anyway, because it's a tablet, right? There are smartphone ones that you can use this for as well. If you have an Android smartphone, you want to do something smaller. The only Android device that I have is a tablet though, so that's why I'm using that, and I like having the bigger screen. So anyway, like that, now we film ourselves like this, and we can see... Now, if you needed your hot shoe for... you know, something else, like you had a microphone or whatever on your camera, then you can still use this setup, but that's why the Gorillapod comes in handy. You can just tighten it onto there, you're good to go. And you can use it as its own stand, or if the camera was on a tripod, you could wrap the Gorillapod around the tripod pole and do it that way. If you've never seen any Gorillapods before, I'll give you an idea. Here's a guitar. There's a Gorillapod. So that's about it for this. I've been really happy with all of the Joby products and the Gorillapod line that I've seen so far. They've been absolutely fantastic. This one is the GripTight mount for smaller phones, which essentially means every phone that isn't, you know, like a Galaxy or one of the larger ones, or even the new larger iPhones. But just a little guy like this. So if you have, this is an iPhone 5. Same idea, you just clip it on like that, and then you can, you know, video, or if you want to do time-lapse stuff with your iPhone, it's easy like that. I'll put the links to these products in the description below. This is the GripTight Gorillapod stand for smaller tablets and the GripTight mount for smaller phones using the same stand. There's a smaller tripod than this if you want for your phone, But this one was on sale in the bundle as a good combo, so that's why I got it. They're available on B&H Photo and Amazon's websites for pretty good prices. Like I said, check the description below for links. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please like and comment below. If you have any other products you want me to review, or if you liked the video or didn't, I'm open to feedback. Also, please subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed the videos. I'll be posting other products like this, as well as doing some more funny stuff and making some vlogs or whatever in the future. So, yeah, thank you very much and take care.